Well, my son Grant was my only child, and he was a wonderful kid. He made me a book when he was 7 years old, Father's Day, called My Daddy and Me. And he took pictures at us at the same age as he was growing up, and put this book together for Father's Day. And I've had it for quite a while, since it was 7 when he had it. But I just happened to notice about a month ago, there was a picture in there that he put in there when he was 2, when he had a fireman's hat on. And I really cherish that a lot. He was an unbelievable guy. I hate to say that he was, because I do believe that he just moved. And I think that when we're done with class here, when we're done and we'll graduate from here, we'll all be together again. So it's really not the end of anything. It's the beginning of something new. And he was a wonderful guy. He is a wonderful guy. I don't believe he was supposed to be here very long, or Robert, because they touched so many people in a dramatic way, and such an impact on people that was incredible. People come up to me all the time and tell me stories about them from the most obscure places, but they were very close and wonderful, good-hearted, good people. Did things in the community and helped others, and made people smile, and always positive, both of them. I was blessed to have such a wonderful child, and it's very hard, but I know my son would not want me to be sad, and sometimes that's a little difficult. But I remember telling him, the sign of a really strong person is when you're beaten and you're down on the floor and you can't get up, you get up one more time every time. So I get up in his honor every day for him. And you go ahead, Mom.
Well, he said a lot of the thoughts that echo how I feel. I spent more time with Grant because he grew up in my area. Robert grew up in Prescott, but of course, many, many visits to my home in California. And Grant was always the sweetest little guy. He literally would give you the shirt off his back. Every Christmas or birthday, I tried to buy him really great things that I thought he would enjoy. Then I'd go up to his house and I'd ask him, "Well, what happened to that?" And he gave it away. He said, "This kid really liked it, Grandma." And that's what he did. If somebody else likes something, it's like talking about somebody giving you the shirt off the back. Well, as a kid, literally, that's what he did. You like it, you've got it. And I do admire that. I mean, he was a tough little guy, stood up for himself and stood up for others. One day we were at the park, and there was this other boy who was a little older, and there were squirrels and ducks there. And Grant was about 5 years old. And this other boy took a rock and started to throw it. And here's this little kid. He takes his hand and slaps it down and says, "How would you like anybody to do that to you?" So he was really just a really warm person. Robert was the type that I never ever heard. He was strong, very masculine, even as a little kid. And I never ever once heard him talking bad about anybody, which is highly unusual for kids, also for adults. Okay? Never did he have a bad thing to say about anybody. And those two boys, after Grant moved here and he went and worked with Robert, and prior to that, they were actually, we considered them more like brothers than cousins, because they were so close and got along so very well. And Robert was just a kind-hearted guy, and he had many, many friends, and he really loved his family tremendously. He really did. And I always felt he loved me and my sister, who happens to live with me, because he'd always try and come up with the most wonderful Christmas gift or birthday gift you know, to think. And Grant did the very same thing. He was great. He'd go to all these garage sales and he'd find these nifty, which was right up my alley because I'm a thrift store shopper. And Grant would get me these great little... And I'm so very proud of both the boys. And like my son said, I feel they were here for a purpose. And this may sound a little odd, but there is so much evil going on in Earth these days. And I figure God has to have angels to help them fight what's going on in this world. And that's why I consider my two grandsons my warrior angels. And I know one day I'm going to see them again. And at my age, it might not be that far off. It doesn't matter.
I want to say something.
Okay, say something.
Both of those guys, those wonderful guys, found the love of their lives.
Yes, they did.
So, Leah Fine was Grant's fiance, and Claire just had gotten married to Robert and 6 months, and it was very devastating for both of those beautiful women, and we hold them like family today, always will, and we encourage them to move forward, and but I do want to make it known that those two women made those guys the happiest they ever were.
Oh, amen. They did.
So they deserve to be mentioned for sure.
Yes, certainly.
And so we're just very thankful to the fire department and everybody and giving our boys a chance. And, you know, the support that we've gotten is incredible. The 100 Club and all the firefighters. And we're just grateful. And so were the boys. You know, they were all in. They didn't do anything half. They went all in, all the time.
So. Oh, I echo those sentiments, really. Yeah. It's just been marvelous how all the families have been treated. I just couldn't believe the outpouring of love and care. I just have to say thank you.
Yeah, to all of you. Yeah. I know that, you know, Robert loved what he did, and just ate it up, and he was the outdoorsman guy, and he was so much a part of, you know, the unit of the guys that he worked with. They were so tight, and the whole community of firefighters, they lived and breathed it, because, you know, I remember coming up to Prescott when this happened, and I got stopped in Congress because, you know, they wanted people to go around the long way, Phoenix, and, you know, the man, the fire chief of Congress, I told him who I was, and I said, can you escort me through there? And he said, yes. And I said, yeah, I lost my son and my nephew. And he said, I know. I lost 19 brothers. So that's when it clicked about this brotherhood and how much it means to all these people that are part of that, and how it echoes out to the rest of the community. It's a family, and they were part of that family, and they embraced it, you know. And, you know, I've never seen anything like it. It's very, very, it's just amazing, really, it is, to see people come together like that and to cry along with us and to support us and to be there for us and unconditionally help us. You know, Grant wanted to be a paramedic, fireman/paramedic, and that was what he was working towards. And Robert just loved what he did, and they gave it their all. And, you know, they would go out after together, these guys. They'd go out to Mexican food. They would go out and do things together. They played frisbee golf all the time.
Yeah, they did.
They loved that. You know, so it wasn't like they just went to work. They were working with their brothers, their family, their friends. They were working together. And they loved the community in which they worked. I ran into a girl in a Mexican restaurant. She told me, I knew your son and I knew your nephew and I knew some of the other guys because they'd come in here and sit at my table. And if I wasn't here, they wouldn't eat here. And that they helped me with the problems that she'd brought. She's having some trouble in her home life. And they came in to talk to her all the time and have lunch. So these are kind of special people, you know. And if you remember, there was 19 nights of the round table. So maybe that's something to do with those 19 too.
Good point, Scott.
Yeah.
Well, as far as, you know, people that were affected by the fires like in Yarnell, and we went there. I wanted to go up to see actually where it happened, and fire department was kind enough, you know, to take me up there to see where it, to be on the spot basically, and came down, and we were in Yarnell, and I think it was the lady in the library, because we're great readers, and we went in the library, and she said, you know, your voice saved my house and saved my life. You know, it was just, and there was other people at various occasions, yes, because sir. I kind of liked going to Yarnell quite a bit. And there was always somebody that would say something, you know, mm-hmm. and how much they appreciated, you know, the work. And I personally never really gave a heck of a lot of thought to fire departments, but when I think of the conditions, and when it's hot outside and the heat, and what these guys did, but they all liked what they did, and that's a very important, because so many people in this life can't really work at what they would like to be.
Yeah.
And these guys, all of them, you know, the other fellas that were there, they loved that. And that's kind of heartwarming to know that you spent your, what time in life you had that you were able to spend it doing what you wanted to do.
You know, so. Those boys had morals and values. They all started right here. If there's any redeeming qualities about me, you can thank my mother. And that's been passed down through the generations, and she's the glue that held the family together. And I want to say one thing. Some of the boys went to Prescott Valley, and some of them went to Prescott, and there wasn't enough room in the morgue. And my mom wanted to go see her grandsons, not see them physically, but be in the same room with them. And so we went down there, and they put my son and Robert in the church part of the morgue, and they were underneath a flag. Their heads were underneath the stars. And we got to walk in there, and I got to put my hands on both of my son and my nephew. And I got to lay on top of my son and tell him goodbye.